Stand on Twitter that a blue tick is placed next to an account that is authentic. The individual has gone through some sort of process that enables Twitter to say that they are who they say they are. The blue tick gives one authenticity in the eyes of Twitter users and was introduced in 2009, and it's been a valuable tool for users of the site. But they've been able to rely upon the fact that they were reading or following the right person, and not someone who was an imposter. Now, whilst the commercial exploitation of the blue tick might not have been the motivation for its acquisition by Elon Musk, it has now been seen as an opportunity to make even more money to the $182 billion net worth he's already reported to have. I began to wonder about the whole question of authenticity. It's something that biblical scholars have debated and disagreed about since the times of the early church fathers. And it still goes on. It's one of those things that we encounter in the life and ministry of Jesus, and he challenges other people about their authenticity, as well as being challenged about his own on several occasions. As well as the challenge, Jesus also recognises simple genuineness in the people he meets and shares with them. He isn't looking for complicated explanations as to why people are doing things. He's looking for a simplicity of faith and a completeness of trust that will enable him to act and share with whoever brings that to the relationship that he has with them. Healings are shared and spoken of when people have brought their simple faith in what Jesus would be able to do and say to them. Sometimes it seems that it is harder for people who are faith leaders in that community to come to him, yet even then a synagogue president is able to ask for help for his daughter. Or in the secular world, a centurion is able to send and ask for help for one of his servants, and Jesus recognises his request. And as the story unfolds, it tells us he's a man of great faith. Time and time again, Jesus takes a simple faith that people offer and enables them to find a new way of life and a new hope. It didn't require them to provide documentation so that they could get a blue tick of authenticity. He takes a group of fishermen, tax collectors and assorted others and places before them his genuine understanding of God. In the journey they have with Jesus, the genuineness that they bring matters, as well as the genuineness of Jesus. He exposes them to his perception and understanding of God, his Father. He gathers them around him to observe the results of faith, to share in the ministry that that faith can give. He sends them out on mission to have conversations with other people and so enables them to be with God and discover that the power of God is not limited to Jesus, but is something they can share in because they know and follow Jesus. A genuine authenticity of relationship matters. But it is not evidenced by a blue tick. It is evidenced by the kind of lives that his followers lead. Well, that's where we come in. We who are followers of Jesus bring both the simplicity and complexity of our living to the tasks of following. Sometimes, you know, we find it much easier than others. Sometimes we too are able to bring healing and hope in the lives of those with whom we live, whom we encounter. Sometimes we, like Jesus, are able to recognise the simplicity of their faith and are glad about it. Sometimes, like Jesus, we find it hard to discover the authenticity of people. Sometimes I suspect we too find it hard to hang on to the authenticity and simplicity of our own faith. When that happens, what do you do? The songs that we sing in our worship, the prayers that we say, are often sung and said with confidence, but there are times when we find it much harder. It is at that moment that I think Jesus knows how genuine we are. The uncertainties we have are part of our genuine humanity. It is to our authentic humanity that the living God comes in Jesus. When we're in that place, he holds on to us with love and understanding. He did it to those who were around him in Galilee 2,000 years ago. He does it for us today. Thank you, Father, for your genuine love in Christ for us and for giving yourself to us day by day and to your world. Amen.
Is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. So I will not be afraid. No, I will not be afraid. Because the Lord is my light. The Lord is my light. Is my light. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. So I will not be afraid. No, I will not be afraid. Because the Lord is my light, the Lord is my light, the Lord is my light.
In the day of trouble, he will hide me. He will keep me safe.
Afraid.